This is my grandma, Colleen. She has dedicated her life to support her 6 children and everyone's dog. Literally, she has adopted my little doggy. But she's also helped to raise most of her grandchildren. She has left a legacy of happy memories with all those who have known her, and I want to celebrate her today by sharing with you her life and what she's been up to for the past 80 years. But first, let's go back to 1939. Colleen was born on September 7th of 1939 in Ione, California. Her parents were Omer Porter Lucas and Jeanette Caroline Clark. Jeanette went by the nickname of Nettie. Nettie, sadly, passed away on June 15th, 1944 at the age of 33 in Sacramento, California, while giving birth to twin boys. Unfortunately, all 3 passed away. Nettie's parents were Lawrence Clark and Wilna Height. Lawrence was born in Marion, Iowa, and Wilna was born in Andersonville, Indiana. Colleen was youngest of 4 and grew up with her 2 older brothers, Gail and Bud, and her sister, Frances. Frances has since left us and passed away in 1991. Since Colleen's mom had passed away when she was only 4 years old, she looked up to her sister, Frances, as an example. Colleen's oldest brother, Gail, lives in Reno, Nevada. And her other brother, Bud, lives in Shingle Springs, California with his wife, Mary Ellen. Her dad, Omer, went on to get married twice after Nettie passed away. First to Ruth Yule, and second to a bigger lady named Mary. Omer had been writing letters with Mary. She was looking for a husband and invited him up. So at the age of 15, Colleen moved to Coos Bay, Oregon with her dad. Mary was a member of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, and Colleen and her dad frequently attended church meetings with her. Eventually, Colleen was baptized a member at the age of 16 in Roseburg, Oregon. After graduating high school in 1958 in Coos Bay, Oregon, Colleen moved to Klamath Falls, Oregon to attend dental assisting school and graduated the following year in 1959. Living in Klamath Falls, Oregon and being homesick, Colleen decided to get on a Greyhound bus and head back home to Coos Bay, Oregon to visit her family. While on that bus, she met a handsome Navy sailor by the name of Gail Nelson, who was on his way home to Washington State. Gail had offered to help her put away some deer antlers that she was bringing back home as a gift. They ended up sitting together the rest of the ride, and the rest is history. At the age of 20, she married Gail Nelson on March 12, 1960. It didn't take long for them to start a family. My mom, Diana, and her twin sister, Delaine, were born exactly 9 months later on December 12th, 1960. Less than a year later, my uncle Dean was born on November 24th, 1961. In 1963, they moved back to Coos Bay, Oregon, and lived there until 1967. Sadly, by winter 1962, Colleen and Gail had divorced. In 1967, Colleen met Stan Story through his sister Helen from church. They were married on June 6, 1967. Stan made a hard life to Colleen and her older children. He expected a lot, but he taught and showed them how to do difficult chores. He was a man that stuck to routines, and they had family home evenings every week and occasional barbecues. Colleen remained married to Stan for 16 years. During that time, they moved around with Stan and his job several times until the kids were old enough to move out on their own. Their first move was to Hawaii in 1967. Soon after arriving in Hawaii, my aunt Katie was born on November 26, 1967. Girl you love and hold her tight, so happy together. While in Hawaii, Dean became accident prone and his left eye was poked out by a black agave plant. He also spilt melted crayons onto his legs. I'm sure these incidents nearly gave Colleen a heart attack as she rushed Dean to the neighborhood clinic. Everyone knows that in 1969, that man landed on the moon. But what most of you don't know is that back here on Earth, my Aunt Karen was also born in 1969, Colleen's fifth child. My mom Diana and her sister Delaine were also baptized by their stepdad Stan on July 4th of the same year. In 1970, they left Paradise and moved to Portland, Oregon. They lived with Colleen's brother Gail for a bit before eventually moving to the Dales in 1972. My Aunt Catherine was born in Portland, Oregon on December 22nd, 1972, the last of Colleen's children. In 1973, they moved to Redmond, Oregon. Then, in 1976, they moved to Bend, Oregon. Eventually, Colleen and the three younger girls moved to Las Vegas around 1976, while the three older kids stayed behind for around 6 months with separate families. In 1978, Colleen moved to Tonopah, Nevada, and at that point, the three older kids moved down to Tonopah to join them. In the desert. While living in Tonopah, Nevada, Colleen worked as a manager at the Village Liquor Store and at the test site as a dispatch operator, home of the Stealth Fighter. Colleen moved from Tonopah to Pleasant Grove, Utah in 1991, where she currently resides.
Some of the best memories and best times that I had growing up with Mom were when we lived in Hawaii. She would pick us up from school, take us down to Waikiki Beach. Back then, Waikiki Beach was not all commercialized and overcrowded and populated. And she would sit and draw pictures and sketch of the scenery that was around and draw pictures of Diamond Head. And then as kids, we would play in the sand, play out on the beach, and then we'd go out and swim in the ocean. But good times.
One of my favorite things about growing up with Mom was when she would make all of the holiday sugar cookies. She used to decorate them, and she would even put our names on them. I remember specifically Easter eggs, sugar cookies in the shape of Easter eggs, and she would decorate them in all different colors with the frosting. I remember Christmas cookies and I think even Halloween cookies. So she was always doing that kind of thing for us, and I have a lot of memories of that.
My most memorable moment with Mom is when we lived in Hawaii. And we were pretty young, and Dean did something wrong. I don't remember what it was, but it made Mom mad. So she put all three of us, myself, Dean, and Diana, out on the front porch. It was dark outside, and I remember being scared, and I knocked on the door and said, "I did it." And Mom said, "No, you didn't," and shut the door on us until she knew who did it. So she was just waiting for the right person to confess. So that's all I remember. I don't remember if Dean finally confessed or she finally let us in. I don't remember.
Probably one of my more favorite childhood memories would have been in our house on Redmond. And I always remember us having a table spread full of candies that she was making. My favorite being bonbons, milk chocolate bonbons. But seems like we always had plates and plates of cookies and homemade gifts, all kinds of good stuff at Christmas time. And Mom just tirelessly baked them. And I also remember that house in Redmond that Mom would be cooking and she would be peeling potatoes or cutting up potatoes and she would hand me a couple. And that always made me feel like I was getting something extra and something special and that we were extra close because Mom gave me a little piece of potato while she was cooking.
One of my favorite memories of Grandma is when we were in Tonopah and Dean came home for a visit. And Dean took one of those wrapping paper long tubes and he placed it under Grandma's bedroom door when she was in sleeping and taking a nap. And he went, and made a bunch of his fart noises. And Grandma goes, "You're not cute, Karen." Like I can even make that noise that Dean makes. I also like that Grandma made my cheerleading skirt for me, and she also made Bambi's cheerleading skirt because Bambi's mom lived too far away. That was really nice of her. And I liked all the really good recipes she cooked for us all the time, like porcupine meatball, which was my favorite.
If something is surprising or you can't believe it, I recall you were saying, "Shush." So I find that I say that more now, like, "Shush." I remember you were mad at me for something. I knew I was in trouble. This was in Redmond, Oregon. And I started to run away from you. I knew I could ditch you because I was faster. But I slowed down just enough for you to catch me because I knew I'd be in worse trouble if I ran away. And so as I slowed down, you reached out and grabbed onto my t-shirt and it tore considerably. So I know that you had great delight through the years telling that story that you ripped the shirt right off Dean's back.
With the way life has gone, it's easy to think about how things would have turned out if you had made different decisions. I'm sure sometimes you feel like you've made some silly decisions throughout your life. We've all felt that way. But Grandma, I want to tell you that we wouldn't be here if you had never chosen to go with your heart.
Happy birthday, Grandma! Today, 'cause today is only here and then tomorrow.